present value of notes receivables. So please take note that present value of notes receivables is equal to the present value of the face amount plus the present value of our interest payment. Please take note that the present value calculation is based on the market value interest rate, depending on the time that the note receivable is issued. Doon magbe-base ang effective rate ng note receivable na yon. So, let us begin by answering this example number 1. This is a non-interest-bearing note receivable. On January 1 of 2018, Company A sold its products to Company B and received a non-interest-bearing note with 300,000 face amount and due on December 31 of 2019. At the time of issuance, the market interest rate is 13%. What is the present value of the notes receivables? So, Company A, nagbenta siya ng product kay Company B. Si Company B, nag-issue ng note receivable bilang payment. Payable for 2 years with a face amount of 300,000 pesos and an effective rate of 13%. So, the given in this problem are face amount of 300,000, an effective rate of 13%, and our N is equal to 2 periods kasi dalawang taon siya. So, step 1, we have to solve for the present value of the face amount first. So, I have the given on top. So, the present value of the face amount is equal to the face amount multiplied by the present value factor. Ang face amount natin is 300,000. Our present value factor is 0.7831. It comes from this present value factor table. You're going to look for N equals 2 and the effective rate of 13%. These they are. And then, their intersection is the present value factor we're looking for. And that is 0.7831. Ito siya. Multiply ito 300,000, our face amount. Our present value factor is equal to 234,930. Step number 2, we're going to solve for the present value of the interest payment. Now, since this is a non-interest-bearing note receivable, our PVIP is equal to 0. Step number 3, we're going to solve for the present value of the note receivable na. It is equal to the present value of our face amount plus the present value of the interest payment. The present value of the face amount is 234,930 plus 0 kasi wala namang interest. And it is equal to 234,930. Now, step number 4, we're going to solve for the discount on the notes receivables. To solve for this, we are going to subtract the present value of the note receivable from the face amount. The face amount is 300,000 minus 234,930. The discount on the note receivable is equal to 65,070. The last step is amortization of discount on note receivables. We will be using this table to solve for the amortization of discount on note receivable. We will start with the date and then the interest received, the effective interest rate, the interest income, the amortization of discount, and then the present value of the note receivable. Now, on January 1 of 2018, we solve for the present value of the note receivable, which is equal to 234,930. That is the present value of that note receivable. Pagdating ng December 31 of 2018, ito na siya. Our interest received is 0. The effective rate is 13%. Now, how do we solve for the interest income? Take the present value of the note receivable from January 1, which is 234,930. Multiply it by 13%, the result is 30,540.9. That is also your amortization of discount. To solve for the present value on that period, you're going to add it to the present value of the January 1, which is 234,930. And The result is 265,470.9. Next, pagdating naman ng December 31 of 2019, the period 2, interest received is still 0, effective rate is 13%. To solve for the interest income, take the present value of the note receivable nung December 31 of 2018, multiply it by 30%, the result is 34,511.217. That is also your amortization of discount. Add it to the present value of the note receivable of December 31, 2018. The result is 299,982.1117. Okay, so that's how we solve for the present value of the note receivable if it is a non-interest-bearing note receivable.